Hi guys, it's Allie with Allie Answers. I hope that you're having a fantastic day. If you've not yet subscribed to my channel, I hope that you will. It helps more people see these videos so that we can do more good. And my goal is to reach as many people as possible so that they will have this vital and important information. Today, let's talk about geriatric physicians. So first, let me tell you a little story. When I was a new mom and my son was probably a little less than a year old, he had a fever and a boogery nose, and it was on a Saturday. I did not know that my pediatrician was open on Saturday mornings. I had not had that experience yet. So I took my son to one of the little clinics that they have in the pharmacies, and I got a prescription for him for an antibiotic, but after a couple days, it was apparent that it was not working. I made an appointment at his regular pediatrician and took him in, I believe Tuesday, maybe Monday or Tuesday afternoon, and I got reamed. My pediatrician had an absolute fit. She told me that the medicine that they had given him was not appropriate for what he had, that the dosage was wrong, which is why it wasn't working. And she said, you know, you can always call us and we are open on Saturday mornings. I had no clue. And she said, we are specialists. Our job is to understand how things work for your child, and it is different than a general practitioner or someone who is used to treating someone from very young to very old. Someone who only specializes in babies or children understands that medication will metabolize different for children. Do you see where I'm going with this? That's right. So let's talk about geriatric physicians, geriatricians. I always feel like when I'm calling them geriatric physicians that I'm calling them old physicians. Okay, so if you are over the age of 65 and you are not seeing a geriatrician, or your loved one is over the age of 65 and has, let's say, complicated medication issues. Say that your loved one has several different comorbidities. Maybe they have something going on with their heart, and then because of that, they might have something going on with their kidneys, and let's just say that they're also diabetic. They might see several different specialists, and these specialists do not usually communicate with one another. The job of a geriatrician is to oversee the care of someone who is over the age of 65. Sorry, my general practitioners, I love you guys, but a geriatrician, that's their specialty. They know about the different comorbidities that someone who is older is going to have. And if that they have this comorbidity, they're more likely to have this one. And so as you go around to all the different specialists, these specialists are not usually communicating with one another. A geriatric physician or geriatrician is overseeing that medication. The advantage of seeing someone like that is that they usually understand the things that are going on with someone who's older. They understand the different types of dementias that are out there. They understand that the side effects of medication are going to be different for someone who is a senior than for someone who's younger. And just like my son was actually given the wrong medication at the wrong dosage, because that person, as well as intended as they were, they did not have the specialty that my physician had. A geriatric physician is going to be able to give your loved one better and more comprehensive care. One of my favorite geriatricians told me one time that people come in with a giant bag of medication and that most of the problem is usually in the bag. That's right. Side effects to medications are a major problem, and then more medications are used to treat side effects, and that is how you have polypharmacy, which is when your loved one or someone else is taking lots of different medication that's all interacting with each other, and God knows what the baseline is anymore. I highly recommend that if you live in an area that has geriatric physicians, that you look into it. A geriatrician is going to give your loved one the very best care. They're going to be able to look at the long list of medications that your loved one is on and make recommendations that could improve their health and their length of life. Quality of life is everything, and traveling from physician to physician to physician is no fun, but you need one physician to oversee the general care of your loved one, especially if they have multiple comorbidities. If your loved one has CHF, COPD, kidney issues, or any kind of dementia, you definitely want to make sure that you are seeing that specialist. It'll be worth your time and trouble, I promise. Wishing you and yours great health and a wonderful day. Take care. Bye-bye.